Hello students, welcome to the 10th class on economic survey, and in this class I will be dealing with the 10th chapter on economic survey. Now, what is this class about? This class basically deals with how India has worked since independence. How India has improved in terms of its GDP per capita income and in terms of improving its health indicators. Now, as far as this chapter is concerned, broadly it has dealt with the improvement in the per capita GDP. Per capita GDP also means per capita income of a person, how this income has increased since independence. And primarily, as far as this chapter is concerned, there has been an intense analysis basically from 1980 onwards. And why this chapter has focused on 1980 onwards? Now, this chapter has focused on 1980 onwards because this was the year when India began to change, when India began to shun its Hindu growth rate. Now, what is Hindu growth rate? Now, Hindu growth rate meant a slow growth rate through which India had passed for about 30 years. Now, why India had witnessed this slow growth rate in the beginning, in the initial phase of its independent years? In the initial phase of independent years, India followed the socialist model of economy. In the socialist model of economy, there was more role accorded to the state as an institution. Market forces were not allowed to operate. And when state as an institution was performing its role in the economy, capital from the foreign countries were not coming in India. And when the capital was not coming in India, it led to the slower growth rate. But from 1980 onwards, what we have seen, that India began to shun its Hindu growth rate. 1980s is also a threshold period for Indian economy, when Indian economy began to reach the GDP of the level above 5%. And from 2000 onwards, we have seen that the Indian economy had also achieved the growth rate of about 8% to 10%. So basically, Indian economy has begun to open. Indian economy has begun to provide opportunity to the market forces after 1980. So in this chapter, we will be dealing basically how Indian economy has worked since 1980s and how this convergence has took place. Now, what is the concept of convergence? I will be discussing it in the latter part of the lecture. So the second thing that I will be discussing is about how India has performed with respect to the health indicators. And as far as health indicators are concerned, this chapter has dealt only with the three health indicators. Now, the first health indicator is the life expectancy. How India has performed on this front of life expectancy since 1980s. And secondly, infant mortality rate. And the third thing is total fertility rate, TFR. Now, before we move forward in this lecture, it is important to understand what is meant by convergence. Now, convergence is very, very important. Convergence basically means how the states which were lacking behind in development, how they have been able to converge, how they have been able to streamline with the main states that were performing well. So we need to understand, first of all, we need to understand convergence. Convergence among the states of India. States of India. And then we also need to understand convergence, how India has performed about convergence at the global level. Now, why this chapter on convergence has been added to this year's economic survey? We have this year's economic survey has added this chapter because the focus of United Nations and focus of the international economic bodies have moved on the issue of inequality. Now, no longer we are discussing the issue of poverty, but we have begun to focus on the issue of inequality, because this issue of inequality is a more big issue than the issue of poverty. In the issue of poverty, we used to discuss only about how the downtrodden, how the people who are lying at the bottom, they are not able to survive, how they are not able to have access to the food, how they are not able to have access to the house, how they are not able to have access to the clean drinking water, how they are not able to have access to the sanitation facilities. So this was something that we used to discuss under the topic of poverty. But under the topic of inequality, we are not only discussing the people lying at the lowest level of the hierarchy, but we are also discussing about the people who are lying at the top of the hierarchy. And when it comes to the people who are lying at the top of the hierarchy, they are very few in number and they have amassed a lot of wealth. But when it comes to the people lying at the bottom of the hierarchy, they are billion in number, but as far as their asset value is concerned, that is very, very low. And this is the reason why this issue of convergence have become part of this year's economic survey. Now, when it comes to how India has performed with respect to the GDP, with respect to the health indicators, life expectancy, infant mortality, and total fertility rate, India has done absolutely well. Absolutely well means in comparison to itself. Now, as far as the GDP at the time of independence, that 1947 was concerned, at that point of time, the GDP was less. But when we discuss about the GDP now, in 2016, the GDP has grown in number. Then again, there has also been an absolute improvement in terms of life expectancy, infant mortality rate, and total fertility rate. So absolutely all these figures have improved. So health-wise, also India has done well since independence. And on the front of economic, that is GDP, India has also done well. But what is more important to be discussed is about the convergence issue. Convergence issue about the GDP. How the states which were less developed, whose GDP was less in comparison to the GDP of the states which were lying at the top of the pedestal. At the top of the hierarchy, there were states like Gujarat. There were states like Punjab. There were states like Maharashtra. And at the bottom, we had states like Odisha. We had states like Bihar and northeastern states. Now, as far as the Indian states are concerned, which were lying at the bottom of the hierarchy, they have not been able to converge with the states lying at the top of the hierarchy. Since 1980s, this convergence, as far as the income of the states are concerned, it has not taken place. So convergence has not materialized. It has not yielded much of result in the domain of GDP. Now, what it means? It means that the states which were lying at the bottom of the hierarchy, their income has not increased with respect to the income of the states which were lying at the top of the hierarchy. They have not been able to come close to these states. So the gap, the hiatus that was existing in 1980s is still existent now. The gap between the rich and the poor state has not reduced. Now, it is also important to know about how this convergence with respect to income has taken place at the global level. अगर दुनिया का हम convergence study करते हैं, दुनिया के जितने गरीब देश थे, उन्होंने इतनी तरक्की कर ली है कि उन्होंने अपना GDP ज़्यादा increase कर लिया, and the gap between the rich and the poor nations at the global level has reduced. And there is another startling fact that the convergence in China has also materialized quite well. Now China is, it's not like that the entire China is developed. There are pockets which are less developed. But these less developed pockets, they have been able to catch with the richer regions in China. So the gap has actually reduced. So this is what matters. Inequality is something that is the most important area that is being focused on. And on this area, China has done quite well in comparison to India. And same is also true about the countries of the world. So basically, it is the failure of India. Now, why India has failed on this front of income convergence? Why India has not been able to perform well? Now, the answer to this question will come from the 14th chapter of economic survey. Now, the 14th chapter of the economic survey has dealt about how the resourceful states have not been able to utilize their resources effectively. How the states which were dependent on the aid from the center have failed to utilize that aid. The gap, the hiatus that was inexistent in 1980s, it is still existent now. And this gap is not only still in existence, but this gap has actually widened. So this is something that is worrying the Indian federal system. This is something that is a cause of concern for the Indian federal structure. Now, coming back to the topic of health. Now, as far as the issue of health is concerned, in the issue of health this year, this chapter on economic survey has dealt with the three aspects of health: life expectancy, infant mortality rate, and total fertility rate. Now, in order to shorten the things, as far as the issue of infant mortality rate is concerned, globally India has not been able to converge with the states which are having lower infant mortality rate. And with respect to the convergence between the states, this convergence has taken place, but this convergence again is not comparable to the levels that has been achieved by the countries of the world and by China. So abhi bhi hamare paas aisi states hai, take the case of Odisha ek side mein hai and Kerala hamara ek side mein hai. Abhi bhi dono states ke beech mein jo infant mortality rate hai, abhi bhi uske beech mein gap bana hua hai. No doubt 1980s mein se leke 1990s tak, 2000 and 2010 tak, there has been improvement ho raha hai, but the major issue hai, what we are discussing here is convergence. Gap kitna kam hua hai, sabse badi aur sabse kam mein gap kitna kam hua hai. And as far as this infant mortality rate is concerned, this has not reduced, it is still there, though it has not widened. Now that another two, life expectancy and the total fertility. Now these are the two indicators on which India has performed good. These are the two indicators in which the convergence in India has taken place, and India's convergence with respect to the countries of the world has also taken place. Now what it means? It means that India's life expectancy is matching with the countries of the world which are having higher life expectancy. So we are getting close to the developed countries which have a higher life expectancy. And with respect to the total fertility rate, again India is matching to the countries of the world which are having low total fertility rate. Now why this is important for India? Total fertility rate should be less. Why this is important? This is important because India wants to put a tab on it, the growth rate of population. Already India is 127 crore plus population is there, and we just want to reduce this burden. And then coming again back to life expectancy. Now the gap between Odisha and Kerala, in 1980s this gap was 27 years, but now the gap that is existing between Odisha and Kerala, it is just 9 years. So Odisha has performed well. The countries which were lying at the lower level, they have performed well. Now, as far as this chapter is concerned, now in order to get more out of this chapter, you must watch this chapter along with the 14th chapter, because in that chapter again there has been issues which have been discussed about the convergence and how states have, different states have performed and how they have performed and why they have performed. So this was all for the class. You can subscribe to this channel. Name of the channel is BrainyIAS. You can contact me at 84594-0000 in case you have any sort of query about this chapter. So this was all for the class. Bye bye. Take care. Have a nice day.